Oh, I apologize for such pedestrian images. Please clear that from your mind with some deep-spirited meditation. Well, my name is Surya Mitha, part-time coffee aficionado, part-time beard grower, part-time obscure JavaScript library developer, part-time Ruby on Rails developer, and finally, full-time artisan. And as you can see, currently I am wearing our classic artisan t-shirt, developed specifically inside the United States. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be making some excellent hipster developer beard grower comb mocha. I wasn't able to get an artisan version, so we just picked this off from Starbucks. So I apologize for the inconvenience that we have caused, because if you do actually have a good heater and a good steamer, the quality of your water will actually taste better in the long run when you heat it up because of the specific molecules within the water. So let's go ahead and fill it up. Now you always want to make sure to be using the highest quality water. We actually source our water directly from the Himalayas, so that we get peak water quality, and our pH levels are actually 25. Here at Artisan Coffee Roasters, we put the art in artisan. So let's go ahead and put that on our heating pad. Again, I apologize for the Starbucks quality. We're gonna go ahead and turn it on, and we're gonna go ahead and let that steam for a little bit. And now let's go ahead and take our AeroPress. So this right here is an AeroPress, and it happens to be the most artisan of all coffee makers because it divulges each individual molecule, and it actually injects one coffee ground in each of those individual molecules, so you actually get a frothy taste when you're actually having the coffee. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to take a filter, and I apologize that the filter is not moldy. Essentially, you just want to get your filter on there. You want to take the top chamber of your AeroPress, go ahead and put it on, and I see a lot of people actually doing this step wrong, where they'll put it like this, and then it's done. But what you actually want to do is you want to put it on, turn it around, and give it a bump, because that will actually increase the molecule production. Exclusive moly and water heated. We can go ahead and start pouring it in the cup. So we're going to make sure that our water is completely in the cup. I'm going to pour a little bit here. We have some extra, but that's always okay. And then we're going to take this exclusive Himalayan water, and we're going to go ahead and take this temperature gauge, and we're going to wait until this water actually cools down to around 79 Celsius. Now that we can see it's heating up over here, we're at around 82 degrees. And the way you can tell whether or not your water is actually at the temperature, because this is a very plebeian way to actually measure the temperature of your water. So a way that we at a Blue Town coffee roasters like to do is that you actually want to put your ear to the water, and then you can hear each individual molecule. So now that we actually have our water heated down to 79 degrees, we can actually take this out. These plebeian measuring instruments you do not need, and these are often wildly inaccurate, so I do not recommend you use them. But again, you just want to employ the ear to the water technique. Right now I can tell we're at about 79 degrees Celsius. And now that we're here, we actually want to pour it back into the steamer to get a good steamer taste. Again, this is a Starbucks steamer, so our coffee won't taste nearly as good as Phil's. But we'll just have to deal with this for now. There we go. Alright. And now, we're gonna go ahead and pour some of this coffee right over here, just to wet the filter. So wetting the filter is really important to make sure that you don't get that tipper taste. There we go. So now that we have our cup inside, we're gonna go ahead and take our totally not Starbucks artisan coffee. This paperclip actually makes it airtight, and it was the same used on many Apollo missions to make sure that the airtight coffee is actually kept in place. Because if released with other gases in our surrounding environments, the coffee will actually reduce from an artisan level by 0.3 percentage points. What we're gonna do over here is we're gonna take our artisan funnel, go ahead and put that on top. We're gonna go ahead and take one scoop, and while I'm pouring the scoop out, let me tell you where we get our coffee from. So our coffee is taken exclusively from Oregon. We actually have dedicated bean growers inside Oregon who live simply off coffee so that they actually divulge themselves inside the coffee that they're producing. So here we have some coffee, and here's actually an artisan method of getting the coffee off. You actually want to put your finger, and you actually want to slowly slide it off. And that's making sure that all the bad molecules don't get in your coffee. Where you want to wave your hand once over the AeroPress, and let's make sure that any air molecules that are next will be taken out. And this creates a temporary vacuum. There we go. We're gonna start pouring. our water into the AeroPress. So now that I have my timer, I'm gonna go ahead and start it. And you actually want to pour in an artisan method, and the only artisan method is to slowly pour around the cup itself. Then you want to go ahead and start stirring our coffee. So we're gonna go ahead and stir our coffee for 15 seconds. We're gonna go ahead and let our coffee sit for another 15 seconds. This is really important to the actual brewing of the coffee because it makes sure that we don't divulge any particular molecules from inside the coffee. Alright. So now we can actually use our plunger, and you always want to put it into an angle to create a natural vacuum inside of the AeroPress. And this is actually the most important part of the AeroPress, where you want to press down very gradually. And they say that if you actually think the beer that you would ideally like to have, the coffee actually tastes significantly better. Alright, and so did you hear that spurt at the very end? So that spurt means that we're actually getting bad coffee. Right, that's going to be all our bad, bitter coffee. So you want to go ahead and dispose of that or give it to the Starbucks employees because they're always willing to take some. So now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and take out your filter. All right. Now your filter, after the first use, will be like this. But ideally, you want to go ahead and throw it in the dirt outside, cover it up with dirt, so that you get that nice mold on it. Once you get that nice mold, your coffee will actually start to taste better. And then we're going to go ahead and empty the puck. And this puck, if you actually spread it out within your beard, will actually elongate it, and it'll make you create even more obscure JavaScript frameworks. So that's the puck that you really want to spread around. So just as an example, you want to take some, and you just want to spread it all around yourself. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take the Nutella that we have here. You want to go ahead and take one good spoonful of Nutella, and you want to make sure that none of that Nutella water is actually on it, and you actually want to put it in here. Now, I understand that a lot of people get their Nutella from places like Target and Costco, but we actually naturally source our Nutella from the Andes. So we're going to go ahead and stir our Nutella in here. And again, we're making mocha coffee, so you want to make sure to stir it in there real well. And we're just going to leave the spoon in the cup over there. We're going to go ahead and take from our artisan fridge. And we're going to go ahead and take some of the finest artisan milk out there. We actually source it directly from Mount Kilimanjaro, where they actually extract milk from cockroaches. Let's go ahead and pour that milk in there. I'm just going to keep on stirring it in there. I'm actually going to take my artisan bottle over here because we want to actually let the water molecules within the coffee actually aerate. So we're going to go ahead and pour it. Wow, that looks beautiful. So now, as you can see over here, we have some residue. We also sell this to Starbucks. We actually want to shake it around a little bit, and this actually aerates the coffee itself. Then you want to go ahead and listen to it to make sure the temperature is exactly 20 degrees Celsius. Take our delicious artisan coffee. That looks beautiful.